Hello, and welcome to the special RSA Conference virtual session, Know Before You Go, Your RSA Conference Game Plan. I am your host, Patrick Stevens of RSA Conference. During the session, all participants will be in listen-only mode. At the close of the presentation, we will conduct a question and answer session. Throughout the presentation, if you have a question, please use the chat feature, which is located in the lower left-hand corner of your screen. As a reminder, this session will be recorded. Following the session, you will receive a follow-up email containing a link to the video replay located on rsaconference.com. I would now like to turn it over to the RSA Conference Director and General Manager, Linda Gray-Martin, to begin the session. Linda?
Thank you, Patrick, and good morning, afternoon, and evening to everybody who's joined our virtual session today. As Patrick mentioned, my name is Linda Gray-Martin. I'm the Director and General Manager of RSA Conference, and I'm joined by Britta Glade, who is our Director and Queen of Content here at RSAC. So welcome to today's virtual session. The objective is really to give you some tips and guidance about RSA Conference to help you navigate not just the venue, but the agenda and all the activities that are going on throughout the week. So before we start, just a question, and if you could raise your hands if you're actually going to be attending RSA Conference for the first time. Great, thank you. Okay, a good number of people, so I hope that you find that the information that we're going to give you today is going to be helpful. So here's what we're going to cover. We're going to start off by looking at the essentials, so some of the basics, some basic logistical information. Britta's going to do a dive into the content. We're going to look at the expo. We're going to talk about some of the activities and special events taking place. We'll talk about social media and how you can get involved with us from a social perspective. And then we'll give you some tips and tricks about the week and some fast-track information for you. And then we'll have a Q&A at the end. So first of all, the essentials, and we're going to start by looking at the RSA Conference campus. So you can see here that there are four main buildings, three of which are Moscone buildings, so Moscone North, South, and West. And then the Marriott Marquis, which is just about a five-minute walk from Moscone, is also part of the campus, and there's going to be an array of activities over there, which we'll talk about in a minute. Now, the funny little trucks that you see on the map here are actually food trucks. We'll talk about that again later in this presentation, but there are food trucks, a total of 12 during the week, that you'll be able to purchase lunch from. So first of all, we're going to look at Moscone South. Now, you can see here the street level. So Sunday, Monday, if you're signed up for any tutorials and training sessions, there's a number of them taking place in Moscone South. We also have a Loyalty Plus Lounge here, which is for our returning attendees. We have a bookstore here as well. Now, from Tuesday through Friday, those rooms will flip into track session rooms. Looking at the upper levels in Moscone South, again, more sessions. So floors 2 and 3, on Monday we have seminars, and then these rooms will flip into track session rooms later on in the week. And then if you go down to the lower level of Moscone South, you're going to come across our first expo, the South Expo. And then you can walk by an indoor corridor that runs under Howard Street, so it's underground, through to our North Expo, which you can see on the map here. And we do have a number of sponsor and association sessions taking place near North Expo, which you can see on this map here. And then just a look over at Moscone West and what you can find here. So street level registration. Now, this is the only place that you can register for RSA Conference this year. We also have a coat check there. We have our materials pickup. So if you're a full conference attendee, where you can pick up your conference bag and other materials. We also have our broadcast hub here. So Broadcast Alley, RSAC TV, as well as a number of help desks. So an information desk, a mobile app help desk, a housing desk, and a concierge service. Level 2 of Moscone West, we have session rooms. And then if you're a speaker at the conference, we also have a speaker office and a speaker lounge for you, and you will be required to check in at the speaker office when you arrive. Then up on level three, we have our keynote sessions. We also have forums, lunchtime forums on Wednesday and Thursday, and we have a keynote viewing area as well. And then finally, a look at the Marriott Marquis and the activities we've got over there. So we have two levels of rooms at the Marriott Marquis. The first, the Golden Gate level. On Monday, we do have some seminars over there. Then these will flip during the week to our Birds of a Feather session, to our Learning Labs. There's another Loyalty Plus lounge over there. We have our peer-to-peer sessions. And then down on Yerba Buena level, on the Monday, we have our RSAC Innovation Sandbox contest, which I'll talk about a little bit later. And then Tuesday to Thursday, we have our Early Stage Expo as well as our Sandbox. And there are also some Learning Labs and track sessions down there. So there's a lot going on at the Marriott. So just a word about registration, and I mentioned this previously. There is just one location this year in Moscone West. We do require you to bring a valid photo ID with you when you check in. Here's the registration schedule. You can see that registration opens at about 2 o'clock on Saturday. Now, it does get really busy, particularly on the Monday and Tuesday mornings. So if you are in town over the weekend and you stop by Moscone, I do advise you to go in and register then and pick up your badge and avoid the crowds. Just one other point I'd like to make, bags larger than 16 by 22 by 9 aren't permitted in any of our conference venues. So we do have a coat check by registration, so it would be great if you could check in any larger bags. So a good number of you haven't attended the conference before, but a good number have. So for those of you that have, you'll know that the Moscone Center has been undergoing construction for the last few years. The good news is this is the last year, but it is still a bit of a construction site. So we do have some staff members who are going to be wearing these bright blue t-shirts. They're going to have bright blue flags behind them. They're there to help you. Any questions you need about how to get around the campus, please ask one of these people and they will absolutely point you in the right direction. We also have a brand new mobile app for you this year, which you'll be able to download at the URL here on this slide towards the back end of this week. On the mobile app, you can view the agenda, you can look at session information, you can build your own personal schedule, you can look at our speakers, who they are, where they come from, what their background is, the same with exhibitors and sponsors. You can view interactive maps of the RSAC campus to help you around. You can also provide feedback on sessions you've attended, which is really important. We urge you to do that. And then there will be select sessions where you can participate in polls as well. So moving on to talk about food, which is always important to all of us. On the Tuesday morning from 6:30 a.m., we will be serving a continental breakfast for full conference pass holders over in West Level 2. Our keynotes kick off that morning on West Level 3, so that's why the breakfast is there that day. Then on Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday from 7 a.m., we have a continental breakfast in different locations, dependent on where session rooms are, so in the South Esplanade, West Level 2, South Levels 2 and 3, as well as the Marriott Marquis. And there are concession stands and more paid food options in North and South in the lower lobbies. I already mentioned food trucks, but just a little bit more information for you. So these are going to be supplied from vendors around San Francisco, and we really do have 12 different very strong options to suit all tastes. They're Tuesday to Thursday that they'll be available on Howard Street and Mission Street, so very close to Moscone. They're open from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m., and they're open to all pass holders and will accept cash and credit cards. And there are also a ton of other good food options around Moscone Center at the Metreon and between the Moscone and the Marriott Marquis, as well as the surrounding neighborhoods. Our Cybrew Cafe is our full-service coffee bar, and we have it in three locations. So North Street Level, South Esplanade, and in the Sandbox at the Marriott Marquis. This will be open Tuesday to Friday. I'd urge you to check the program guide and the mobile app for full details when you actually arrive on site, but full conference pass holders will receive one complimentary beverage each day. So just a word about hotel shuttle buses. So we do have shuttles to and from our San Francisco hotels in our housing block and the Moscone Center. So those that are located in San Francisco itself, they run every 15 minutes during peak service hours and every 30 minutes during midday service hours. If you're staying over at the airport in one of our hotels over there, the buses run every 30 minutes during peak service hours, but there is no midday service to the airport hotels. You can see detailed route information out on our website on our hotel shuttles page. The URL is here. If you're staying over in Oakland and Emeryville and you booked through our housing bureau through On Peak, you will receive a complimentary clipper card, which is valid for up to 5 round trips on BART and or AC Transit to get you into the conference easily. And wheelchair accessible transportation is also available. And the details here, and there will be details on site as well. We just ask you to wait or allow 30 minutes for service. Okay, so we're going to now move on to content in the expo. And at this point, I would like to hand you over to Britta Glade.
Super. Thank you, Linda. And thank you all for, we've got great questions coming in here. Keep them on coming. So I, as Linda, well, Linda introduced me as the queen of content, which with the British accent sounded really neat. But yes, I work with all of our speakers. We have over 700 speakers participating in a variety of individual sessions, panels, peer-to-peer, learning labs. We have so much variety of content that we are bringing to you this year. And we're in those final stretches of deck review and deck posting. Please do keep checking the website. We are posting final decks of our presenters' materials as they are approved by our program committee. We know that that's something that's helpful to our attendees, is for you to be able to see that content beforehand as you're debating between various classes. So those things will be being posted really up until sessions are taking place throughout this week and into next week. You can – actually, Linda, will you go back 1 second?
Oh, sure.
Linda got trigger happy there on my slides. So for those of you, I did notice about a third of you on this call, this is your first time at conference. So in addition to, and hopefully you've come across this, but I did want to make sure you were well aware of the different types of sessions that we have. In addition to the traditional sessions, we have peer-to-peer sessions. Those are sessions that are limited attendance. It's limited to 30 attendees, and it's a facilitated conversation. So this can be a really great opportunity to get to know some others who maybe share interest in a particular topic. It's a discussion that you're having amongst peers for 45 minutes. Those, again, are taking place over at the Marriott Marquis in a very nice boardroom-style room, good opportunity to get to know some folks. And then learning labs, which are also in the Marriott Marquis, those are, we've got two different types of learning labs. We have a 64-person version. We have a 120-person version. We have 2-hour versions. We have 4-hour versions. But those are interactive, hands-on experiences. Both of those are limited to only signing up for one. You can sign up for one peer-to-peer and one learning lab because they are highly popular. They do. They're very, very good experiences for the attendees in the room. So I would encourage you to check those out if you haven't already. And then certainly the keynotes, the forums, and all the other sessions that we have are great. And then on the next slide, scheduling. This is another important thing. As Linda will cover later in the presentation, carefully thinking through your attack plan for this whole week is very important. Obviously, the sessions that you're attending, that's part of your full week experience. There's many other things that you're doing as well. But do take an opportunity to plan what you're planning to participate in this week. We've got many questions coming in the Q&A queue about the mobile app that will be available for download later this week. You'll be using your app to be planning. You can also be scheduling online. Planning, looking at having a first choice and maybe a couple of other options. You know, maybe you get caught long somewhere, so you're going to pop into a room that's closest to you. As you saw from Linda, the campus is, there's 4 distinct buildings where classes are taking place. So thinking through how you're moving through that space and what you'll be planning to attend. So do take some time Think about what you're planning to schedule. You can do keyword searches on our site to find recommendations, you know, classes that, you know, that's what they're going to be covering in there. You can look at things by track. You can look at things just in terms of what's happening in different blocks of time. Lots of different ways to approach going about scheduling your day. But do be purposeful coming into the week, because otherwise it can quickly become overwhelming since there's so many things going on. And on the next slide, we'll review actually reserve a seat. So for those of you who've been before, at least if you were there last year, we introduced this functionality called reserve a seat. And this is our way of helping you with your planning for the week. It also, frankly, helps us to plan for the logistics for the week. But you have the opportunity to go in and reserve a seat for all the classes that you want to attend. You can only reserve a seat in one class in one time slot, because obviously we can't have you can't be five places at once. But if you reserve that seat will be held for you up until 10 minutes before the start of the session time. So think, you know, just like with an airline reservation, you have your seat, where you're planning to go. Your seat will be given away 10 minutes before to those who've lined up in the queue. But do use this opportunity to help you plan your week. We, from a planner perspective, we use this information to help us as well. It helps trigger for us, oh gosh, we need to have this session in our overflow room. That helps us to determine, so we can help ease up some of the line things. We can make room changes, and we have lots of different sizes of rooms that we're utilizing that we can make sure we can accommodate the most people who are interested in specific topics. So it helps you with your week. It helps us to make sure we can give you the best experience possible. Do go through and reserve your seats, and then that will show up also in your app with what your schedule is for the week.
Great. Thank you so much, Britta. And Britta will be staying on the line to help answer any questions that you have about content. So just a little word about keynotes. So I've already mentioned that the keynote room is over in West in level 3 in the top floor there. Space is limited. We do have plenty of seats, but if you really want to come and see the sessions in person, then get there early. We do have alternate viewing areas as well. So we have one just outside the keynote room on West Level 3. We also have one on West Level 2, and then in a couple of rooms on the Tuesday only, also on West Level 2. And of course, you can watch the majority of our keynotes live streamed online on our website. RSAC On Demand, we're really proud to introduce this. It's a brand new program that we've literally just launched. And it provides participants the RSAC experience without leaving home or the office. So if you have colleagues or people that you know that cannot attend the conference for whatever reason this year, this would be a great program for them. So we ask people to enroll, and once they do, they can access select live stream sessions plus on-demand recordings during or after the conference, including our industry experts track, where we have some fantastic speakers this year. And then we're also going to be recording four of our Monday seminars, including some very relevant sessions on GDPR, which I know is top of mind for a lot of people, and securing diversity. As an RSA 2018 pass holder, you'll get an email shortly detailing how you can access this program right before the conference. And now just a bit of information about RSA CTV and Broadcast Alley. Again, I alluded to these earlier. They're over in West on the street level. So RSAC TV is really one of our broadcast programs. We'll be streaming select 15-minute presentations and interviews live from Moscone West. We're also going to be including some of the very best of the content that we have distilled down into digestible segments for you. We're going to be publishing videos which fall under this program. And more information is available out on rsaconference.com/RSACTV. Broadcast Alley is a new initiative this year. It's where some of the top leading security publications are going to be shooting live from the conference. They're also going to be recording interviews with various attendees and some cybersecurity VIPs. We have a drop-in booth if you want to capture an interview or a discussion, where we supply an equipment and crew. You can sign up for half-hour slots, and for more information, you can contact the email address here, information@rsaconference.com, and your question will be routed to the team. So moving on to talk about the expo. So this year we have a record amount of sponsors and exhibitors. We have 650 across two expo halls. So the two expo halls, north and south, are open at the following times. It all kicks off on Monday at 5 p.m. when we have our welcome reception. And then both halls will be open through the week until Thursday at 3 p.m. So this is a little bit hard to read, but we wanted to give you a feel for our expo floor plan. This is our North Hall, so you can see some of the larger sponsors and booths in the middle there, surrounded by some of the smaller exhibit space. Bottom right, you can see a briefing center where our silver and bronze sponsors will be presenting 20 and 30 minute sessions. And there are some sponsor meeting suites down there as well if you're from a sponsor organization. Looking at our South Hall, again, more of the same, lots of sponsors, lots of exhibitors, and another briefing center there as well. Now, the two, it's probably a 2 or 3 minute walk between the two floors, so it's not too far, so we would encourage you to go to both if you can. And new this year, we're introducing our RSAC Perks Pack. So if you're a full conference pass holder, you will receive a booklet when you check in at that materials pickup over in West, and it will contain exclusive sponsor offers and coupons. It will give you the chance to participate in giveaways, drawings, and more from the sponsor booths. You just need to take that booklet to the relevant sponsor booth and redeem it for prizes and other conference perks, and your perks pack will look like this graphic here on the right of the slide. So we've already talked about the Marriott Marquis, but I just wanted to drill down a little bit into the specific details of what actually is going on over there, because we do have some really good stuff taking place during the course of the week, and it will be worth a visit. And many of you might actually be staying there as well. It's one of our primary hotels. So we talked about the floor plan already, but here's just a list of the different activities that are going on, and I'll talk about a couple of them in a minute. So we have our Innovation Sandbox contest on the Monday. We have Early Stage Expo and RSAC Sandbox, which take place Tuesday through Thursday. We have some seminars, we have learning labs, we have peer-to-peer sessions, and Birds of a Feather sessions. So our RSAC Innovation Sandbox is really one of the leading platforms in the industry for startups to launch groundbreaking research and innovation. It's really for cyber's new innovators. So the top 10 finalists that have already been chosen will be pitting against each other and competing to be named the most innovative startup of 2018. So this event, it always gets really packed. If you're really, really keen to see what's coming down the pike with innovation and cyber, it's really worth your time. It's taking place Monday from 1:30 to 4:30 p.m. And it gets busy, so definitely get there early. Our Early Stage Expo is going to be featuring 45 of the emerging InfoSec startups, so another really innovative space. As I mentioned before, it's open from Tuesday for full conference pass holders Tuesday only, and then one-day pass holders for Tuesday also, as well as the Cybit Ops ticket holders. Wednesday and Thursday, it's open to everybody, and these are the times that it's open. Definitely worth a visit. Then our RSAC Sandbox is something a little bit different. It's going to provide you with interactive experience to test and sharpen your InfoSec skills. So some of the sandboxes on offer will be studying the impact of automobile and the Internet of Things vulnerabilities. SANS NetWars is going to be in its space. And you can also experiment on what happens to healthcare and energy sectors when our critical infrastructure is tested. There's just a few things we've highlighted. So on the Tuesday, it's open only to full conference pass holders. And then for the rest of the time it's open, to all badge types. And another new offering this year, Nighttime Ninja Sessions. So these are also at the Marriott. They're on the Tuesday and the Wednesday evenings, and they're mainly sponsor-hosted sessions, but some really fun and interesting stuff for you to take advantage of. Available to everybody on a first-come, first-served basis. just a few highlights here. So GDPR, again, you're going to hear a lot about that at the conference this year. GDPR and EU privacy laws, updates from the battlefield, best practices in network availability, and talking about scalable networks, just three examples of the Nighttime Ninja sessions. So now we're going to talk a little bit more about other special events and activities. So first up, the first social event on the calendar is our welcome reception. This is on Monday between 5 and 7 p.m., taking place in both of our expo halls. It's a really great opportunity to get an early look at some of the new products and innovations by our sponsor companies, and all of the leading names in the industry are going to be there. It also gives you a chance to have a drink, have some light food, and network with your peers. On Tuesday, we have our RSAC Women's Leadership Reception. This is from 5 to 7:30 p.m. It's a really great opportunity for all the ladies that are attending the event, and we're celebrating the talent contributions and continued development of women throughout our cybersecurity community. It's located at the Press Club, which is actually opposite the back entrance of the Marriott Marquis, so very close to Moscone Center, and it's open to all conference attendees and cybersecurity professionals who support women in the industry. On Wednesday, we have our pub crawl once again in the North and South Expo Halls. It's just an hour and a half. A lot of our exhibitors and sponsors will be having some beer, wine, and non-alcoholic beverages on their booths. And if you refer to the Expo Guide when you get on site and receive your program guide and Expo Guide, you'll see which exhibitors are taking part in this. CyberOps is our fourth annual craft beer tasting event. If you like craft beers, this really is going to be a great event for you. It's on the Wednesday from 4:30 to 6 p.m. It's over in the Sandbox Early Stage Expo space in the Marriott Marquis. It's free for full conference pass holders, for Tuesday full conference one-day pass holders, and those people who have already purchased CyberOps tickets. It's open to people who are 21 and over, of course. And here's just an example of some of the craft beers that we're going to have on offer. It's always a really fun event. And then the culmination of the social activities from the RSAC perspective is our RSAC Bash on Thursday, which is located at the iconic and very historic San Francisco Armory over in the Mission District. It's going to be a lot of fun, very interactive. We have a Grand Prix remote control race course. We have retro arcade games. We have VR gaming. There's musical entertainment. There's photo booth options, interactive lounges, food and drinks. It's a really fun event. We will be providing shuttles from Moscone and also the hotels that are going to be running during the evening. It's really going to be a fun night. And our RSAC Security Operations Center, we introduced this for the first time last year for those of you that attended. It was really, really popular. You can take a tour of a working SOC to see what's taking place on the Moscone Wireless Network in real time. It's located in Moscone North on street level. As soon as you go in the doors there, it's open from Tuesday to Thursday and is sponsored by Cisco and RSA. So I just wanted to make you aware of RSAC Advanced U. So this is really a new initiative where we've brought together a number of programs that we offer. Just a few things that are rolled up into this program. We teach cyber awareness for parents and for children. We provide outreach to college students to encourage careers for them in information security. And we support education throughout various stages of careers. So I already mentioned the CyberSmart Parents Education Workshop that takes place on Monday. Our Security Scholar Program is for around 60 of the best and brightest students that we have and exposes them to this fantastic content we have, to expert leaders and visionaries, and really gives them some great insights into cybersecurity today. On Thursday, we have our RSAC College Day, which is for current students or recent grads, and it gives them full conference access on the Thursday. And then we've already talked about RSAC On Demand. So taking a quick look at our social media channels, there are plenty of different ways to engage with us. Our hashtag is here, hashtag RSAC on Twitter. We also have a presence on Facebook, LinkedIn, YouTube, and others. So please get engaged with us. There's going to be a lot of chatter during the week. So then the final part of today's presentation, before we move on to Q&A, is just some tips and tricks. Now, these have been put together from feedback we've received over the years. Some of them may seem very self-explanatory, but it's not until you get there and realize how much ground you cover that you really wish you'd read these. So just a couple of things. Pack for comfort and convenience. And also, I would add to this list, if you've got a Fitbit, definitely track your steps because you're going to be taking a lot of them during this week. Wear comfortable shoes. Pack a battery phone charger. We do have some charging stations throughout the campus, but it's always good to have a spare battery phone charger with you. And don't leave your hotel without business cards. Now, Britta alluded to this. Plan ahead. You know, not just for sessions, but also for the expo, because it's a busy week. If you want to get together with a top executive, it's better to do it earlier in the week, because sometimes they just come in and out for a couple of days. Schedule sessions now. Use that reserve a seat functionality and get a place in the sessions that you want to go to. Talked about the bash. It can be a really good place to network. And always have a backup plan, and Britta mentioned this too. So reserve a seat for those sessions that you want, and if you don't, just come with a backup plan in case the session that you want to go to is full. Take care of yourself. So although the campus is pretty close together, there is a little bit of a distance when you walk and you meet someone that you know and you end up speaking for a few minutes, and then before you know it, it takes half an hour to get from one place to the other. So just keep that distance in mind when you're scheduling meetings and the sessions that you want to go to in the expo. Don't go too crazy and burn yourself out. Try and sleep well, eat regularly, hydrate. There's lots of options for you for food and beverages throughout the venue. And then we just touched on this, being smart about the expo floor. Come with a plan. It's huge. There are 650 sponsors and exhibitors. So, you know, really think about who it is that you want to spend time with and make a plan to target them throughout the conference. So I mentioned this at the beginning when we talked about registration. It is only in West this year. Monday and Tuesday really are the busiest times. So if you are in San Francisco over the weekend, from 2 o'clock on Saturday, you can pick up your badge and other materials. So it's really worth doing if you want to beat the crowds. From a keynote perspective, the busiest ones tend to be the opening keynotes on the Tuesday morning and also the closing keynote on the Friday afternoon. So just a note, turn up early for those ones you really want to see. We've got a fantastic lineup of speakers again. And as I mentioned before, you can watch the keynotes in our alternate viewing areas in Moscone West on levels 2 and 3, as well, of course, as online. And just a friendly reminder that rsaconference.com is the only legitimate website for RSA Conference. So there have been a few things going out over the course of the last few months promoting websites that aren't the official one. However, this is the only legitimate official website for RSA Conference and is your source for everything, rsaconference.com. And with that, we are going to go to Q&A.
All right. Thank you, Linda, so much. So we've got a bunch of questions that have come in. I will start with the first one with, can you explain Loyalty Plus a little bit more, and how do I know if I am qualified?
Yes. So Loyalty Plus is for returning attendees, and I think it's for people who have attended five in the course of the last few years. So you will have been sent details of the Loyalty Plus program already if you're part of it.
Great. Britta, this might be one for you if you can handle it. Why are many amazing sessions overlapping, and is there anything I can do to schedule them and ensure I get to those sessions?
Wait, were you overlapping sessions, did you say?
I mean, so many amazing overlapping sessions.
I'm glad you're seeing amazing things. And that's the bummer of it. You know, we try not to pick anything that's not amazing. And we try to have many, many options. What we try to do is not have things with similar content running at the same time. If you care deeply about blockchain, for example, we're trying to make sure there's not a blockchain session that's going on at the same time. That said, we do realize there's many, many things that look of interest. And honestly, I'm glad that things look of interest. Now, one thing actually that I was just thinking that we didn't cover that actually would be relevant here, and this is something we introduced last year, we will be audio recording many of our sessions. And then we sync that audio with the slides. So while you won't see, you know, a video of the person talking, you'll hear their voice, you'll see the slides advancing, you'll see all of those all of those things. So it's you know, just about like being in a session. And that will be available on our site, you know, in the months following conference, just like many of those are on there from last year as well. So that's our way of trying to help you cover not being able to be in 10 places at once.
Thank you, Britta. And Linda, could you just repeat what the attire for the conference is for those that might have missed it earlier?
Yeah, and actually I think it's a good point because we didn't actually talk about it. But, I mean, it's really people wear whatever they want and anything goes. But I would say generally it's casual, business casual, whatever you're comfortable in.
Great, thank you. And Britta, could you just explain the rule around more than or less than one lab or seminar being able to reserve a seat for?
You bet. So you can reserve a seat in one time slot for regular sessions. So you can't reserve a seat to be in three different sessions at the same time for obvious reasons. But for lab and peer-to-peer, we do limit people to reserving a seat in just one peer-to-peer session and just one lab because those sessions are so small and so specialized. You know, by design, we know that our attendees really value that networking time, and that's why we set these things up to be small. We're limiting people to only reserving a seat in one. Now, if there's something that you're really, really interested in, go ahead and show up there. Make sure you're at the front of the line in that queue so that if someone doesn't show up and those seats are open 10 minutes before, you have a good shot at getting one of the open seats that emerges. So anything that opens up 10 minutes before is fair game for anyone, but you can only reserve a seat in one peer-to-peer session and one lab.
Perfect. And Linda, if you can, to give a guesstimate, I see some questions coming in as how many attendees we can expect throughout the whole week.
Yeah, and we won't obviously know until after the conference. The next kind of couple of weeks are key. What I will say is last year we had just over 43,000 attendees overall. We're trending positively right now, so we would expect that more and maybe a higher number, but we don't know at this point.
And one more time for the entire group, can we just expect the mobile app to be released anytime soon?
I would say at the back end of this week, a communication will be going out.
Great. Now, there are still questions coming in.
Hey, Patrick, I'll jump in with one I see, which is, are you going to post all presentation materials following the conference? The answer there is yes, unless the presenter doesn't want us to be posting their materials for any reason. The bulk, I would say 80% of slide decks will be up before conference even starts. Keep checking those pages. The speaker management team is loading those as they're finalized and approved by the program committee throughout this week and the weekend and into next week. But yes, all presentation materials, unless the speaker prohibits it, is posted to the conference site.
Great. Thank you, Britta. Linda, I've seen this question pop up quite a bit. Is there anything spouses can participate in? Are they allowed into the expo hall or anything else?
If spouses want to attend any social events, then they have to purchase tickets, which they can do at registration. And so anybody that enters the conference venue does need a badge. So even if they want to attend just the expo, then we just need to have them registered first. Okay. And I saw a question actually, Patrick, about the size of bags permitted in the conference venue, which I mentioned earlier. So, you know, regular backpacks are fine. It's what we're trying to avoid is people bringing in large suitcases and taking them around the different venues, especially with that amount of people walking around, it can get dangerous. So we just ask that people check them at one of the coat checks. Obviously, a regular handbag or a backpack is fine. Just the dimensions we try and stick to are 16 by 22 by 9.
Great. I will actually take a question myself. All of the slides from today will be published at rsaconference.com as well as the video replay, so you can access it there if you didn't get to listen to the whole presentation from Linda and Britta today. And Linda, could you just highlight one more time where the food trucks outside will be?
Yes, I absolutely can. So the food trucks, I'm going to get the exact location for you, the street names. They are going to be on Howard Street and on Mission Street, so right in the middle of the Moscone Center areas. So there are going to be 12 of those food trucks featuring different kinds of foods from around San Francisco.
Awesome. I think we'll take one or two more.
I see a good one. I'm going to hop in on
it,
if I can. On the session planner, I was not able to see the location of the session I'm attending. How can I see that info? We actually just, you are probably someone who is a planner, a header, so good for you. We just added the location information yesterday. I believe it was yesterday, day before yesterday. Again, we look at the reservacy, we look at where people are going to be, and we try to match rooms to where we see demand. So if you go into the site now, all of that information is there. Now I will give the caveat of, you know, our mobile app and website will be where the latest, greatest information is kept for locations. We would notify anyone in the event any location changed. But the room information is available now.
Great.
All right. Britta, do you see any others coming in?
Let me scroll through. Looks like food trucks are going to be popular. We have people excited about the conference bag already. Yes, we do work hard on that bag and try to make it fun and interesting every year. Will there be shuttle service to and from BART? I can answer that just as a local. BART is two blocks away. So yep. The shuttle service will be your feet, which is awesome because then you don't have to wait for a shuttle at any given time. So it really is very convenient and easy getting back and forth to BART.
Absolutely. And I think I mentioned this, but if you are staying at one of the hotels, you want to check shuttle service, then go to our website, look under the hotel shuttle page, and you will see a list of all the routes and which hotels are included and which route. Or route, I should say. Sorry.
With your American accent. One question that I see right now from someone, if a session is full, is it possible you'll move to a larger room and then it will become available for reserve a seat? As I indicated, we reserve the right to move spaces. We try not to do that too heavily, and if we move rooms, we would not move them outside of any of the physical buildings. Again, there's those four buildings where things are at. We don't want to drive you guys crazy by doing too much movement. But if something, for the most popular one in any slot, we will run it in our overflow room. So the overflow, and that will be indicated. That will be indicated on the mobile app. There'll also be digital messaging at the location that'll say overflow room available for this. This is the location. And then I did see another question about, do we know which session? You know, as I had indicated, we do record and sync with slides some of the audio for these sessions. We do know what those are. I believe we've indicated that online. If we haven't, I will go back and make sure we have indicated that, just so you know. Just so you know, if you're planning between, as someone indicated, there's so many awesome things going on at the same time. That's music to my ears. But I also want to make sure that you do have the opportunity to listen and hear and learn from that content later. So we'll make sure that information is communicated.
Thanks, Britta. I will take one myself. Is there a place to log in as a registered user on rsaconference.com? If you're looking to reserve a seat, visit the session and events page under the agenda, main agenda, and log in using the My Schedule feature on the right-hand side of the page.
I see a good one. How do you know which sessions will be used for CPE credits? Linda, do you want to address that? Because I know CPE is popular.
Yes. So now correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe that every hour of education you can earn a CPE credit. So ISC Squared, we work with them to when you register, you give us your member ID, and then we work with them to share the sessions that you've attended so that they can figure out the amount of CPEs you get. I believe that for ISACA and for others, it's self-reporting. Hope that makes sense.
And that's one reason. So we use, when you're scanned into a session, that's the data that gets reported out on your trip report that you submit. So that's one of the reasons you scan into the sessions.
Good point. Thank you for that.
One more for you, Linda. For full conference pass holders, or anybody in general, I believe, will we get a pass to use public transport for buses, et cetera?
No, we don't offer that. The only thing we do offer is that if you're staying out in Oakland or Emeryville, you get that Clipper card to get you into the city. But other than that, we don't provide attendees with San Francisco transportation cards.
Ooh, I see a good public service announcement that one of our attendees made, and I love that you had this experience. We have a lost and found station, and this individual had the experience last year of leaving their phone in one of the sessions, and someone turned it into the lost and found in the Moscone West Atrium area. Is that where lost and found is going to be again this year, Linda?
It's at our information desks.
Great. So the information desk, and that's great. I'm glad you had that experience. Yay.
Sorry, one question. I mentioned the Clipper card. You will be given the Clipper card when you check in at your hotel, if you're staying in Oakland or Emeryville, as long as you booked your room through our housing block.
And then I'll answer one more from a local perspective, which is, are there trains from the airport to Moscone building? What you will want to do is take BART, B-A-R-T, Bay Area Rapid Transit is what that stands for. There is a BART station right at the airport. You can take the BART right in next to Moscone. What's the exit they would want to get off on? It's the one right by the Marriott Marquis. And literally, again, Moscone's two blocks from the BART station. So it's all very, very easy. If you go online and look at BART's website, you'll see that. You'll see the schedule, and it's very, very easy to manage.
Great.
Great.
Oh, Powell Street, someone said, yes, that's good. That's a good exit to take. Lots of people, lots of locals who are, yes, Powell, it appears to be that is the correct stop to get off on. Someone says, how long to Uber? I'm assuming you're talking about taking an Uber from from SFO, yes. That entirely depends on what time of day you're taking it. If you're at rush hour, it could take you an hour. If you're not at rush hour, it could be as fast as 20 minutes. So it really depends on the timing that you hop in that Uber.
Great. Thank you so much, Britta. And I think with that, we are going to wrap. So thank you to our presenters, Linda, Britta. You guys did an excellent job with this discussion. And thank you all for joining us for this RSA Conference Know Before You Go virtual session. We are looking forward to seeing you all next week in San Francisco from April 16th to the 20th. For more information in general, please visit rsaconference.com. Thank you. You may now disconnect.